What's up, guys? Welcome to Finance Discipline. Today, I want to talk about cryptocurrency a little bit. I want to give you a quick overview of everything that I've learned about crypto. The best way I can describe crypto is that I think we are living in an unbelievable time for opportunities, guys, for people to make a lot of money in crypto. There's many other opportunities too, but crypto is very, very, very different. Because crypto, basically, it's doing what we see technology is doing for everyone. And it's doing it like in a way that is crazier than everybody, everything that you ever seen. First of all, I want to start out by saying, guys, we all gotta wake up. We all gotta wake up. I want you guys to understand something. There's a lot of things going on in this world right now that are extremely good. There's basically there's never been a better time to stay alive than this time around. And I personally believe that it's not the government that's gonna help us. It's not totally the job of the government to make our life better. It's gonna be technology and innovation. Let me explain to you what I mean. There are more billionaires now than ever before. Like Kim Kardashian just became a billionaire. Kylie Jenner became a billionaire. But let's forget about that. Let's talk about the working class. The working class right now have better opportunity now to become entrepreneurs. That's a fact. Now, let's talk about crypto. In crypto, there are people just like you and I that can create their own currency. Think about this. That's called crypto mining. So we're going to get into that. But so I just want to let you guys know that this channel is about that. I'm learning about crypto. I'm teaching you about things, but I'm going to do it in my special style. My style is like, I'm not going to try to make it extremely complex with a lot of drawings all the time. I'm just going to be plain and simple to you and talk straightforward to you so that you can understand. Okay. The stage one of the human life, there was no money available, right, in the world. Nothing. And humans used to trade animals and horses. Okay, so animals and horses were traded. That's the way people used to deal with each other. Stage two of the economical system, we started to use precious metal, coin, precious metal. And so like we started to use silver or gold, right? That's what we did to deal with like, so remember, stage one, animals. We're trading animals, we're trading wild things like horses for 2 cats, horses for 20 cats, horses for like 50, horses for 10 cows, you know, weird things like this. But sometimes what was difficult with that kind of like strategy is that if I have 10 cows and you have two, you have 20 horses, let's say if I have 10 cows, I don't want to really buy the horses. I want to buy something else. So, and if you have 20, if I have 10 cars and you have 20 horses, let's say you want to buy something from me, I don't need those horses. I don't want them in my house. You understand? So that's why we went a little bit more sophisticated in the history of mankind. We went to like coin, precious metal, gold, precious metal, and silver. We went to that location, and then the British pound was pretty interesting. The British pound was based on that. One British pound is made 1 British pound of silver. Is the pound is the silver, the weight of silver. So that's the way we used to do it. That's all we did. So now we have like so now what is good about that is like you have a coin, a metal of coin, and then we traded those dollars, those golds, and those silvers. So silver and gold became currency. Now we got rid of that. Stage three, we went to the banks. Now the banks, they print currency, they print a dollar sign, and the dollar sign is like a receipt, a proof that you own a certain amount of money. It's like a receipt and proof, but the dollar has no value in itself. The gold had value. The dollar has no value. But the banks were in the government was able to say that this dollar has value, not the banks, the government. The government was able to see that the dollar's value. So that's the way we move forward. We became more sophisticated. Now we're dealing with paper dollars. But now we got rid of paper dollars. It's like we went and we started to do transaction on spreadsheet. Those are the Amazon days, the credit card days. Remember credit card days? We started to do like you never see the money. You do. So it's a bunch of spreadsheet. This bank has a spreadsheet. This other bank has a spreadsheet. We trade the currency. We trade things, and then there's like what is it? Account payable and stuff like that. And then you're watching the profit and the expense. You're watching all those things, right? So that's the way we work with the credit cards. So basically, you owe me. If there's $140 that you want to buy this thing, $140 is deleted and it's put into the other account, ledger in the other account. That's the stage four, the era of credit card and Amazon. Now we are stage five. And what we are doing basically, we are trying to do everything virtual. So the currency, the cryptocurrency is totally virtual. There's no like metal. There's nothing like, it's unbelievable. There's no like metal. There's something tangible to it. There's nothing tangible that you can touch. And for me, crypto is good and bad, but I feel like that's the danger of it because it's all virtual. Like the way I feel, this is the way I feel about it. Like if something is all virtual, what if the power turns off mysteriously in the world? And what if like the biggest virus in the history of the universe, that is 50 times more powerful than like everybody else destroys all the data. What's gonna happen? You think all those data is gonna be inside people's memory? It's not. So there's always that risk that I fear. But maybe I need to learn more about crypto, but that's the fear that I fear. So the good thing, the funny thing about crypto is a transfer, the way crypto is a transfer of digital asset. So everything is digital. You don't and what's good about it? It's like you don't need multiple banks. You don't need like 100 banks. It's like it's one big ledger that keeps account of all the transaction. One big spreadsheet keeps account of all the transaction in the world with Bitcoins, with crypto. And remember something, you don't need all the cryptos are the same. The Bitcoin that you have in the United States is going to be the same Bitcoin in France or in Uganda and Ethiopia. Okay? It's going to be the same. So those are the good thing. So what is cryptocurrency? What does it do for you? It's decentralized, right? So it's decentralized the money. And what I like about that, it makes people less powerful, which is also good. Guys, I want to tell you something. The way I look at technology actually. People, a lot of people out there are saying that, oh no, we need the government to step in to give people student loan or to give people things to help create equality. I actually think that the technology is going to create its own equality mysteriously. Like you heard of the invisible hand. I think that's what might happen moving forward, guys. Like I really believe that. I think like the world is moving in a place where like everything's going to be like the technology is going to be so powerful that you might be able to become a billionaire or millionaire if you know what to do. You have to be on top of those opportunities. You have to know what is something that you can do to make your money. So that's the way I feel about this, okay? So there's no need of multiple banks. What do banks have? They have like hierarchies and there's a powerful man on top of the bank. So we got rid of the banks. Now think about this. Anybody can create their own cryptocurrency. Another thing. So that's what I'm saying. Technology makes the world like, well, more people can become rich, more people can get involved in things so that we're not like waiting for one man to elect us, which is good. So I'm pro technology, I'm pro innovation, I'm pro crypto, all those things, you know? Okay, so now I don't know if you heard of that. You heard of that probably many times. Crypto mining. What is crypto mining? Crypto mining is like, let's say I'm a dude and I have like very powerful computers. And I can set it up so that I can crunch all the transactions that are going on a spreadsheet. So there's like about 1 million Bitcoin miners. Let's say there's 1 million Bitcoin miners in the world right now. They're working, they have big computers that are watching all the things, all the transactions. Because all the transactions, they have your name, they have a tracking record, the time that the transaction was, so that we keep all the spreadsheet, everything intact. So, you know, so that everybody is on top of it. And what's good about that? You do not need banks. There's no exchange rate, there's no transaction fees. That's another thing. So the banks, like I heard there's a way that with crypto where you can earn 8% return. The banks don't steal your money like the old bank that they used to do, like the mafia. So with crypto, we're gonna get rid of the banks. Guys, remember I told you this. I think there's a possibility that we are starting to merge into the beginning of the end of the bank, of the banking world. I think this could be the end of it. Like, well, there will be no more banks. And I don't know, that I think that could be a good thing, guys. I don't know, I'm not fully sure yet. We have to be careful what I'm saying. Maybe 100 years from now, by the way, because I think things are gonna move slowly. So people, a lot of people out there in the world are trading crypto for dollars, and that's what they are doing, guys. So they are trading crypto for dollars, and a lot of people are jumping in the game, including me. But I'm not 100% yet, and I have not made a big money yet, but I'm investing and I see the potential, you know? So and I see the money potential you can make. That's why I started this channel. This channel is finance discipline. Of course, in trading, you gotta be disciplined, but I can say one thing. Crypto, if you invest now, in 10 years, you can have a lot of money because it's gonna be so volatile, it's probably gonna take over the world and everybody's gonna become like so rich with this thing. Like, you know, that's what I think. But there's a couple of like things that you should fear. This is what you should fear. It's very speculative. Crypto is very speculative, so it's all speculation. And crypto is also not accepted as a form of payment in many banks. It's not accepted as a form of payment. So that creates a lot of problems also. Like, you know, like so crypto is not accepted as a form as a sort of bank. So and it's a crypto is like it's very volatile. And that's the thing I see. And crypto has no real value. Everything is online. So those are the risks that you have to understand. But like, look at the world like that. Like, it's weird, but like, it's almost like the credit card also had no real value. I mean, we started to move in that world once we started to do the credit card. The credit card, you get a card and they tell you there's money in it. You don't see the gold, you don't see the silver, there's nothing tangible, you don't see the money. They tell you there's money in it and they put a number on the credit card and that's the money in it and you go buy things. So that was the beginning of the virtual currency kind of thing. But now, we are going all digital. I hope we're gonna succeed in this. I'm gonna start investing in more, a little bit more. I will let you know. But there's so many things to learn in crypto, and there's a good way to make a lot of money. I'm asking you to please support me, subscribe to my channel. We're gonna move together, you know, up. Because right now, I'm just like you. I'm learning, and I have a degree in finance. I understand finance and international finance. I have that. I understand all those things. I'm a trader. I have trade. I've done okay, not that bad on regular currency, you know? Okay, so this is what I want to say. When it comes to investing and all those things, what I'm telling you today is has nothing to do with go ahead and invest in crypto or Bitcoin or nothing like that. If you take the risk, it's on your own. This is not a professional advice for you to go ahead out there and take a risk because you know this is just like for educational purpose only, and that's it. Okay, so I'm not telling you to take a trade. I'm not telling you to take a risk. Those things are things that you have to do on your own with a manager, financial manager. I'm not that. Okay, so it's just educational purpose only. So, guys, please subscribe to my channel and let me know what you guys think. And please comment, please. Thank you.